In this video, I'm going to make a simple sound synthesizer with Pygame and Numpy in Python. Before we start, we have to have some basic understanding of what is a sound wave. Sound waves are pressure fluctuations which travel through the air or other physical medium and hit your eardrums. We can generate those waves with a speaker, which usually consists of a diaphragm with an electrical coil attached to a permanent magnet. When an electrical signal passes through the coil, it vibrates the diaphragm, which in turn moves the air around it, creating the sound waves. The electrical signal consists of an alternating current, usually created by a DAC, digital to analog converter, and is amplified by an amplifier. Before that, the signal is digital, consisting of ones and zeros in your computer. And what does this digital signal look like? Basically, it is a long list of numbers. So, how do we generate a digital signal? It's actually not that complicated. The first thing we should consider when generating a digital signal is the sampling rate. That is, how many values we need to define for a second of sound. The default value for the Pygame mixer is 41,000 samples per second. So that's what I will be using. The second thing is the form of the wave, responsible for the quality of the sound. It is the reason why different instruments sound so dissimilar for the same frequency or pitch. The most poor waveform is sine, also one of the easiest to generate in NumPy. But there are numerous other types, like square, triangular, and sawtooth. We will start with the sine wave, which will actually be generated by a cosine function. It makes things easier for triangular waves later. Cosine is equal to the sine but with a phase shift, which is not relevant in this context because it sounds exactly the same. To generate the array of values of a sine wave, we need the sampling rate, the frequency, and the duration of the sound sample. With the duration and the sampling rate, we can calculate the number of frames that the sound sample will have. With the number of frames and the duration, we can generate an array with the timings of each frame, which in turn is fed into the cosine function multiplied by 2π and the frequency. This results in an array with all values of the sound signal. To hear it, first we have to turn it into a Pygame sound array, which first has to be multiplied by the value of 32,767. Duplicated for stereo mixer, transposed and turned into the int16 type. Then we can use the function make sound from Pygame sound array. The copy is necessary to make the array contiguous in memory. Finally, we can play the sound. Careful with the volume, it will be at the maximum. After that, we simply wait for the duration of the sample and exit Pygame. Great, now we can do the same for all the notes on a piano keyboard. But wait, what are notes anyway? Simply put, notes are selected frequencies which often sound nice when played together. This may sound a bit weird, but the exact frequencies aren't that important. What matters the most are the durations between them. The most used ratio in Western music is the 12th root of 2. So, to generate samples for all the keys in a piano, we just need a list of all the notes, which conveniently I have listed them in a text file. Then we just need the frequency of the first note, 16.35 Hz, and the remaining frequencies can be calculated from it. So we can easily store a sample for each note in a dictionary. For the keys, we are going to use the characters in a regular keyboard. After all, that's what we have to play here. The 108 keys can be subdivided into 3 groups of 36. Since your keyboard probably does not have enough keys for all of them at once. Now that we have all the samples, we can start playing and try to make some music. For that, we need to create a Pygame window, so we can capture the keystrokes and play the corresponding samples. A note starts playing when a key down event is registered and stops after the duration of the sample or when a key up event is registered. The range of notes can be changed with the keys 0, minus or equal. Okay, this works, but this blank screen is boring. Why not put it to good use? To display the notes on screen, first I'm going to define a position and a color for each one. For the positions, I have arranged all the notes in a grid of 12 by 9, neatly spaced on screen. For the colors, I try to mimic a rainbow, where the lower sound frequencies are reddish, the middle ones are greenish, and the higher ones are bluish. The positions and colors are also stored in the notes dictionary. The notes are then lit into the screen. When playing, the current note gets highlighted with a white color, and after the key up event, it returns to the original color. After some adjustments, we have a very basic and somewhat pretty sound synthesizer. Now, with this simple keyboard synthesizer, we can start making some music. Or at least try. But the sine wave sound is a bit dull. We can explore other waveforms for different sounds. There are proper ways to generate square and triangular waves, but for this project I came up with some simple hacks to approximate these types of waveforms. The square wave can be approximated easily by multiplying the sine wave by a big factor and clipping the result to the -1 to 1 range. 10 already looks squarish to me. I know, it's more like a trapezoidal wave, but it is close. Triangular waves can be built on top of the square waves with integration. This is done with the cumulative sum function in NumPy. After that, we only need to scale it back to the -1 to 1 range. This method works more or less fine for short samples, but cumulative errors may creep in for longer ones. Here we could go wild and try to come up with more interesting waveforms. For example, adding up multiples of the bass frequency, we can have interesting results, and theoretically, we could mimic the timbre of any instrument. Now we are able to play any music. Well, not me. I don't have this talent. But maybe after some practice, who knows. But what if we manage to play an epic sequence? How can we save it for eternity? We can always use a recording app like Audacity, using the computer speaker as its input source. But this only preserves the resulting sound, not exactly the notes which were played. There's a better way. Store all the relevant key down and key up events in a list and later save them to a text file. But music is not just a sequence of notes. Timing is arguably as important as the notes that are being played. This is why we also store the timestamps for each event. Before saving them to a text file, it's interesting to turn the timestamps into time intervals, which are easier to handle in playback. The type of the event is also stored as a binary value. The final result is a text file with all the notes that were played, when they start and when they end. This can also be modified in a text editor for adjustments and corrections. To replay the sound sequence, I think it's better to start a new script, but we can borrow most of it from the previous one. The main difference here is that there are no real key presses. Instead, the program waits until the time for the new note to be played. So the keys in the notes dictionary are the notes themselves. This makes more sense for creating music, as the actual keyboard keys are not relevant. This script allows us to create and fine-tune sequence manually in a text editor. I have tried out something like that with a part of the Super Mario theme song. The previous script allows us to replay a sound sequence, but with all those weights, it is not practical to integrate it into something like a game. Instead of playing note by note, we can generate an array with all the samples we need and play it at once, or even save it to a WAV file. Before we start, we need to make some adjustments to the synth function. First, we add a fade to each sample to replicate the fade out used on the key up events with a length of 0.1 seconds. So, no notes shorter than that are allowed here. Also, we don't need to turn the array into a sound, but to a list, because this way it is easier to add a new sample to the end of the track. The notes dictionary is much simpler this time, as we are only concerned about the frequency of each note. After that, we go through all the notes in the sound sequence and generate a sample for each one of them, to add to a list. The samples are extended while the breaks are reduced by 0.1 seconds to account for the fadeouts. At the end, the list is turned back into an array and into a Pygame sound. A weight of the length of the sound is added to ensure that it's fully played. Finally, we can export the track to a WAV file using the WAV library. And we are done. The only limitation in this approach is that there are no overlapping notes in a single track. We could, but this is messy. And we can always generate multiple tracks and combine them later. To add to arrays, they need to have the same length though. Well, I think that was it for this video. All the code is on my GitHub. Thanks for watching, and until the next time.